This has been episode 131 of the Call Me Crazy Show, the best of year 7. And I just want to tell you, thank you very much for watching it. I hope you found it hilarious. And if some people believe that the show if the show is a little offensive, then all I can say, don't watch it. Okay, I'm out of here, people. I gotta go to work. 131 episode. But now the countdown has begun. Now we have a little more than a month for Revenge of the Sith, the most anticipated Star Wars installment, I think, since Phantom Menace. But it's pretty much the last Star Wars, and it's gonna be pretty sad when it's over with. But the good news is that the Clone Wars will continue, and I was told by an identified source at ILM that there will be a TV show about minor characters. Until then, people, we'll be doing pre-Sith things. Hopefully you'll see some nuttiness, but I have to go. Bye-bye, people. Okay, another interesting thing that she wrote was a survey given to pizza delivery driver said that people who answer the door naked or nude tip better than people who answer with clothes on. What is that movie with that freaking Patrick Dempsey guy? What's that name of that movie?
Oh, Lover Boy.
Lover Boy. There we go, people. There we go. U.S. soldier, and I've seen all the medals that he won. And I think he's a lot more presidential than W. Bush. Okay, people, I gotta go. I have a long day ahead of me, but I gotta take off. And unfortunately, people, I have to work two jobs. Now, we're also learning about the Bush twins, the daughters of George W. Bush and Laura Bush. We'll get to Laura Bush later in a little bit. But anyways, they graduated from college, and you know what? Whoopie fucking do, because there are people dying in Iraq. People dying here in the U.S., and George W. Bush is saying, oh, I'm so proud of my daughter for fucking graduating from doing drugs and drinking underage. Okay, and then also last night, I was hanging out at home for a long time, since I hung out at home on a Sunday night. But anyways, I was watching TV, browsing through the television set, when I happened to catch fucking WB Superstar program. I don't know what the full title is. But anyways, I thought the most hilarious thing ever. It makes American Idol look kind of tame compared to what Superstar does. It also makes me want to join Superstar, just because I would love to be one of the singers. And then if they want to hear the worst singing ever, I can do that. So I would think I could do my version of being punked. I could punk them out on fucking WB Superstar. But anyways, I saw those guys doing the audition, and they were pretty horrible people. But you know what? What cracked me up the most was the fact that the producer is one of the judges on the show, and he was cracking me up because, for instance, he said to one of the contestants, who was a really good singer, by the way, the good singer did a real nice vocal melody and whatnot, and the producer turned judge said, knock, knock, and the young man said, who's there? And the judge said, you suck. I thought that was hilarious. I was cracking up for like 5 minutes, and you know what? I had to turn it off after that because I felt very bad and embarrassed for the contestant. Because every time when they cut to commercial break, they will say, and will they know that it's only a big practical joke? And then I heard a little thing where they told one of the contestants that this is like a practical joke. And I heard one of the contestants say, are you fucking serious? And they bleeped out fucking, you know? And so it's like, serious? So it's like, I want to be able to see the end of the season where they tell the winners, like, hey, you're the butt of all the jokes. Because I'm pretty sure there'll be a Jenny Jones incident where the guy's going to pull out a gun and there's going to be murder on live TV. Okay, people, that's it, folks. I got to get out of here. Movie news, Van Helsing is out with Hugh Jackman, who plays Wolverine in the X-Men series. But Van Helsing is getting a lot of attention because I guess it's the first summer movie. And then Shrek 2 came out a couple days ago on Friday. A lot of people saw it. A lot of mixed reviews. But overall, number one movie in the country. And also, what I'm looking forward to for summer 04 is Spider-Man 2 with Dr. Octopus. And then the music note. The only thing I'm going to recommend for the summer 04 is, Winning Days by The Vine. And fuck it, I know it's not 03. But Eyes Adrift, I'm going to vote for Eyes Adrift for Album of the Year again for 04. But anyways, I saw Scary Movie 3 a couple days ago, a lot better in Part 2, cracked me up. I hope for the day when it's like Scary Movie Hot Shots Part 8, you know. It's going to happen. It's like going to be, you know, like Hot Scream Part 9 or whatever. And then on the somber note, a lot of people are dying. That's what's happening in the world right now. Okay, people, I gotta leave, but I gotta go to work right now. But all you people in Afghanistan, Iraq, thank you very much, Tucson, Arizona, for listening to me on this Memorial Day, because it's a very special Memorial Day. And I hope George W. Bush remembers that. He is happy ass is up in Camp David. Up in the East Coast somewhere, having a great time. You know, he says he's very proud and happy that his daughter graduated from the college. What's so great about that? We have U.S. citizens dying for nothing in Iraq, that in the country they wanted out of already. We were able to get the dictator out. George W. Bush is glad and happy and proud that his daughter graduated from college. All I gotta say about that is that his daughter don't know shit from Shinola, that they should have been shipped to Iraq on the first wave of the military that had to go over there. Why don't the Bush twins, how can the daughter don't go over there and entertain the soldiers? Are they too good for them? It makes me wonder. All I know that the twins are good for, the Bush daughters are good for, is that they're good for partying, I heard. So, you know, screw them all. I hope they all fail in life, and I hope their dad fails in life, too. And I hope he doesn't get reelected. And we'll talk more about John Kerry. And people, I got phone calls coming in. I gotta go. Let's see. I just want to say I hope Dick Cheney suffers a heart attack. I hope he suffers a massive stroke. And then I also want to be able, since I'm going off today, I want to be able to go off on Laura Bush. I remember back when the Clintons were back in the White House, Hillary Clinton tried to do a lot by doing health care reform. You know, she tried to do some of that. She managed to write a book, It Takes a Village to Raise a Child. She's pretty much an accomplished woman. She's very smart. Too bad that she had to go through what she had to go through after what Bill Clinton did in the White House. But look at her now. She's a U.S. Senator from New York, for New York. She's very prestigious. She's the number one most influential lady in the country. Right before Oprah, who listed at number two. But Hillary Clinton did more in one day as the First Lady of the White House than Laura Bush has done in the past 4 years as First Lady. I can honestly say that I have yet to see Laura Bush do any worthwhile cause or speech that is inspiring to the people and to the women who make up half of the country. And Laura Bush, I'm sorry, she does not have what it takes to be First Lady. On top of that, she has an ugly haircut, you know, and you can't even see a lip. So she's an ugly woman, she has ugly kids, and she's married to an ugly husband. That's all I gotta say. And I hope John Kerry wins.
The whole entire country and pretty much the whole world seems to be in a lot of turmoil. Let me start off with the death of Ronald Reagan. Ronald Reagan was an evil man. Let me put it to you this way. Ronald Reagan was a man of no integrity. He had no love for anybody, only himself. And Ronald Reagan didn't do nothing for this country at all. For all you people who like Ronald Reagan or who love Ronald Reagan, that's okay. It's a free country. You can do whatever you want to do. But in my book, Ronald Reagan was an evil man. Just because, here's the deal, people. I found out a couple months ago that Ronald Reagan, when he was in office as President of the United States, he signed the Martin Luther King Jr. law into effect. And I don't know if it's true, but I read that during the signing, that the people in the White House room started singing "We Shall Overcome," which is a song okay, people, this is the Call Me Crazy show. This morning I saw the new cover of the Newsweek magazine, and believe me, people, I'm a huge fan of periodicals, but I was so ticked off at Newsweek because guess who was on the cover? A picture of Nancy Reagan kissing the coffin of Ronald Reagan. All I have to say, Ronald Reagan never picked up a gun and went to war. So whatever, Ronald Reagan. Too bad you didn't even know that you went away in the end. If you were balling like a huge ass pink rose, baby ass baby in the adult underwear, I hope that on your deathbed that night that you were choking to death on your vomit. Because Ronald Reagan, You're a very bad man, and I think right now he's in hell. Only he knows himself that he's in hell. Ronald Reagan's in hell along with Saddam Hussein. Saddam Hussein might be here in this world physically, but spiritually, he's in hell. But it's so sad to think that in the world where we're living, where U.S. soldiers are just being swiped and mopped, and so much attention is being paid to an old man who already lived his full life, who didn't do anything for the country, it gives a sad reminder on how Americans think. So.
appreciation moonlight drive. Approach with caution, you will not die. Appreciation moonlight drive. Approach with caution, you will not die. Don't blame it on me. Freedom ain't free. Darth Maul, don't fall. Jedi Master, Sith Lord, too late. Darth Maul, don't fall. Jedi Master, Sith Lord. Approach with caution, you will not die. Appreciation, moonlight drive. Approach with caution, you will not die. Don't blame.
Most likely asked. I need a drink. Han, if Leia knew you drank so much, she would have married me a long time ago. Ah, the thing who'd have done in bed. Whatever, Jawa, I already have slept with her anyways. I can't believe I lost my lightsaber. Ben is gonna kill me.
Ben? Ben? No, dumbass, it's me. What are you doing here? I'm here to give your pathetic lifesaver back to you, boy. You took my lifesaver? Yeah, you pathetic loser. I just want to have fun. Emperors just want to have fun. Girls just want to have fun. What the hell are you talking about? Anyway, this lifesaver is located right next to you. Thank you, Your Highness. Your Highness? Fuck you and your kids. I feel sorry for your mama. What you say about my mama? He said he feels sorry for your mama. Thank you, Ben.
What up, Tucson, Arizona? This is the Call Me Crazy Show, episode 125. Sorry if I haven't seen you guys. I've been on a Christmas vacation. And before I begin, I told a couple of buddies of mine, Ray and the cleaning crew where I work, I told them I'd give them a shout-out. And here I am giving a shout-out. And Sam. And I want to give a shout-out to pretty much everybody who I ran into for the past 4 weeks. And I want to say thank you, City of Tucson and TCCC and Tucson Cable Access for making the Call Me Crazy Show possible. This is my 125th episode. I can't fucking believe it that I've been doing this for 7 years. And hopefully 05 will be a great year as time goes on. And now here's the kicker that I wanted to talk about that Marty talked about on his show a while back, 2 weeks ago on his live show. The end of television, Friday night, every other week, 9 o'clock, is that Tucson Citizen editor, Mark Kimball, he's also featured on the roundtable segment from, on Channel 6, on Arizona Illustrated, and me and Marty happened to catch this show last week, and if mildly interesting, Mark Kimball. I don't say that your show is the worst show of all time, but anyway, Mark Kimball, he's a columnist for the Tucson Citizen also, and he wrote on back in July of last summer, July 2004. Mark Kimball wrote a column about Tucson public access, and basically saying in the column that he couldn't find any reason to think of what the good side of public access if it existed. But he chose rather to dwell on the bad aspect of Tucson public access. And he basically talked about some of the shows that Mark Kimball taped that over the prior weeks. And he happened to catch, guess what, people? He happened to catch the Call Me Crazy Show. I don't know if you can see it, but I'll try to do it. The Call Me Crazy Show featured a guy sitting in his backyard and rambling. Kathy Lee Gifford is leaving the morning show, and all I gotta say, who gives a flying fuck? Or as in the word of Mark Kimball, featured, insert Cheney word. Call Me Crazy read a letter from an observant viewer, and no, people, that Mark Kimball put observant. He's basically putting my show down, our show down. He read a letter from an observant viewer who noted, your cable show has to be the worst thing I've ever seen in my life. And all I gotta say, Mark Kimball, thank you very much for your compliment and time for featuring in the Call Me Crazy Show from the Ponder Chitlin production household. So Mark Kimball, I hope you continue on your little rant on, I hope you continue your little rant on, whatever it is that you talk about on the round table. And hopefully one day you'll get to see this new episode of the Comic Crazy Chill, and maybe you'll get to see a picture of yourself right there. This guy is a viewer of the Call Me Crazy show. If the editor from the Tucson, if a columnist from the Tucson Citizen can watch the Call Me Crazy show and all the other countless local cable shows, then we must be doing something right. So thank you very much, Mark Kimmel. Thank you very much for mentioning the show. And thank you very much, viewers, for staying in tune. I gotta go. I'll see you next week. Long live public access. And if it wasn't for public access, you know what, if you shut down public access, you might as well say freedom of speech is over.